Welcome to the first episode of my Unitail Crash Course. In this series, you will be learning how to create awesome and unique Unitail battles. This course is aimed at newcomers to Unitail and coding in general, so no prior knowledge of Lua is required. For clarity's sake, I am using the Create Your Frisk version of Undertail, which is a version with more features that's still being updated. All you need is a text editor like Notepad and, of course, Unitail installed on your computer. If you don't have Unitail installed yet, I have a tutorial for that on my channel as well. Anyways, let's get started. From the folder where Unitail is installed, go into your mods folder and copy the Encounter Skeleton folder. Give it a name like Tutorial 1 and open it up. You will be greeted by three folders: Audio, Lua, and Sprites. Audio obviously contains all audio files for your mod, and Sprites contains all images for your mod. Let's focus on the Lua folder for now. Inside of the Lua folder, you will find another set of three folders: Encounters, Monsters, and Waves. Let's just focus on the Monsters folder and open it up. Inside this folder, you will find only one file. Wait a second.
Poser.
Ah, yes. Poser.lua. Open it up in your text editor. You will be greeted by this. If this looks confusing or intimidating, don't worry. We're only going to focus on this small section in this tutorial. Let's look at what we've got here. A few similar looking lines with a word on the left, followed by an equality sign and another word or number on the right. These are what programmers call variables. Each variable has a unique name and holds a specific value. On line 7, for example, a variable called name holds the value poser. If you have guessed that the variable name specifies the monster's name, then you're correct. And since the file is opened in a text editor, we can change the name. But first, let's see what the battle looks like before changing anything. When accessing the fight menu, the only option is poser. Same case with the act menu. In fact, when selecting check in the act menu, the name poser appears at the top of the check message as well. So let's change the value of the variable name to something else and see how that affects our battle. I'm going to change it to creator. Let's restart the battle and voila! The option in the fight and act menus has changed to creator. The check message also displays the new name. Not all variables are equal, however. They can be of different types. As you may have noticed, some variables keep their values in quotation marks, like name, while others don't, like HP. This is because the variable name is of the type string, which is text, while the variable for HP is of the type float, which is a number. This typing ensures that the name always consists of one or multiple words, and the amount of HP is always a number. This brings me to the next point. When modifying the variables you see here, make sure that you leave the quotation marks intact. By removing the quotation marks, you are changing a variable's type from a string to something else. This can cause all kinds of issues, so know what you're doing when removing or adding quotation marks. Now, let's change more variables. We will modify the amount of health the enemy has. Let's increase it to something like 200. Remember, no quotation marks. Now when we attack the monster, the health will decrease at half the speed. Before we change another variable, let me introduce you to another type of variable, the Boolean. The Boolean differs from strings and numbers as it can only hold two valid values, true or false. Let me show you how a Boolean works by modifying the variable canCheck. It is currently set to true, which means we can use the check command. Let's set it to false and see what happens. The check command has disappeared from the act menu. Set it back to true and we can check the monster once again. Because the check command is either available or not available, the variable storing that information only needs two states: true for available and false for not available. That's why it makes sense for it to be a Boolean. It's great that we can change variables, but let's add an entirely new one. For that, I'd like to show you a page in the Unitail documentation. In your Unitail folder, open up the folder Documentation and double-click to open the HTML file at the bottom. A new tab in your web browser will open with this page. On the left, click on Special Variables and scroll down to the section Monster Script Variables. The example shown here looks similar to our file, but there are variables which aren't in our file yet, like gold. Let's give the player some gold for winning the battle. In our Lua file, add this line somewhere. The location doesn't matter, but to keep things organized, I'm going to put it below defense. First, we specify the variable's name, in this case gold. Then comes the equality sign, which is needed to assign a value to a variable. Lastly, the value itself. In this case, it determines the amount of gold the player will receive. Let's set it to 42. Now, when we defeat the poser, we get 42 gold. And that's it for this tutorial. In the next one, I will introduce you to functions and how to change ACT commands. Creator out!